everyone, wherever you are in your respective parts of the world. Hopefully you find this a very helpful session, looking at a student's journey from having been receiving an offer to a university and starting their journey to their destination country. And what do they experience when they arrive, and how do they get to grips with this new destination? So this will share some insights around that, and hopefully also give you some insights into what's available that we have in place to help and look after our students. So let me share my screen and we can get started. All right, Pratibha, can you just confirm that's all visible? Thumbs up.
Yes, Chris, we can see your first screen.
Fantastic. Okay, so let's go. Student Essentials. What is Student Essentials, and how does it help our students as they navigate this journey to their new destination? Well, really interesting starting point. A student gets an offer, they accept that offer, and we're off. We're going to go and study at our university, at our destination. It's really exciting, but now what? So what do I do next? How do I get ready? How do I know what to expect? How do I know what support's available? What do I need to get in place? So excitement can quickly turn to anxiety and it can turn to concern. And IDP has a whole journey here that helps support the student through this process. And we'll talk a little bit about that together now. So what we have in place is a bunch of options and tools that help support our students. We call Student Essentials. And at this moment of anxiety, I guess the answer is don't be anxious, we've got you covered. And I'll talk a bit about this as we go through the rest of today's presentation. But first, let's hear a little bit from our students. IDP has spent a lot of time researching what our students' experiences are, both when they initially leave the country, when they arrive at their destination country, the first month in that destination country, the first 2 months, 6 months, year. What's it like? What are the common things that students experience? What are the common things they need? And what's available to help them in that journey? So let's hear from our students. And to do that, as I said, we ask them what they want. What do they really, really want? What do our students require? What help do they need? When do they need it? What do parents need? And when do parents need that support? Parents put their kids on planes. They go to this destination country and they worry. So what do parents need as well? So we did some research and came up with four common areas that are really important in this journey for our students as they head to their destination. The first is they really want to be successful. The feedback from our students were, we're undertaking this journey because we're trying to achieve our dream, our aspiration, and we're trying to deliver on the expectations that we have on ourselves and our family has on us too. We want to be successful. But we also want to be able to settle into the country that we are arriving into. We want to understand the culture. We want to understand the way in which that country works, how the people live, what the food is like, what the sports are like, what the entertainment's like. And we want to settle comfortably, and we want to settle safely, and we want to settle in a way that we can work for us. The other piece is social, and this has come up very strong in the research that we've done. Students need to connect with other students. Other students going through the same journey as them, other students that have already gone through that journey, social with just making friends, feeling secure, building that group of connections that help you navigate this new country, this new world that you're in. And then finally, very big call out for support. Support around when I get stuck, help me. When I have a requirement, give me a solution. When I have not sure how to navigate a particular part of either shopping or part of finding food or part of transport, give me some support to help me do that. So very clearly, our students have focused on these four things as the themes of feedback. Help me settle, help me connect socially, get me access to support and make it easy for me to be successful. So let's be students for a little while. So we're all going to navigate our own journey as students and experience what they do when they arrive in these destination countries and experience what they go through and the different types of things that they can confront. And everything I'm going to share with you comes from the research that we've done across hundreds of students across multiple destinations at multiple stages in their journey, both departing the country, arriving 1 month all the way through to 2 and 3 years into their journey. So you'll now experience that based on what the research has told us as our students experience their journey. So first of all, let's look at what type of journey do students typically have. Well, first of all, you accept the offer from a university. Fantastic, great, I've got my offer. You then prepare to depart, you then arrive, and then you start this journey to succeed. But there's a bunch of sub-journeys underneath that, sub-things that you experience. You arrive, you undertake sometimes your study, you may need to require some work. Sorry for that. You look for additional work, you look for engaging with your friends and the people that you've created relationships with at the university. And you do this at different parts of that journey, before arrival, 1 month, 1 to 6 months, 6 to 12, or 12 months. And those points down the bottom in orange seem to be the key moments of truth for students as they experience this journey based on the research that we've done. So let's go a bit more into the detail of what that actually looks like. So you'll see on the left-hand side of the screen here that you have the support piece along the bottom in blue. That's the stuff that's what needs to be available to help you in that journey. And then you've got those components we spoke about earlier, to be settling, social connection, and trying to create that success that you are setting out to achieve. So before arrival, we run at IDP a series of pre-departure seminars. We invite students and parents into our offices. We share details of the destination. We share examples of what to expect, practical things. You know, what's the cost of a car? Where do I go to get food? How do I navigate public transport? What help is there from the government if I get stuck? What help is from the university if I get stuck? So we brief our students with all this type of information to arm them with what they need when they're looking to arrive in country. And when they arrive, it really is about being welcomed into that destination. So the students are very clear that that first period of up to a month is very nerve-wracking. It needs to have support wrapped around in terms of welcome, in terms of simple things like picking me up at the airport to get me to my destination, ensuring my accommodation is organized so I have a clear place where I'm going to stay, ensuring I have banking services, ensuring I know whether the shops are, where the theatres are, where the cafes are, where the university is. And so that first month is really, really important to be welcomed into that country in a way that is secure and safe and allows me to navigate that start of my journey. And around sort of 3 weeks in, lots of questions start to come up. Questions about how does this work? How does that work? And that's when things like down the bottom in this blue support channel, having access to a buddy, having access to someone that can support me in that, can answer those questions, and can actually access people that have done this before. And we're very fortunate with IDP that we have offices in Australia, we have offices in Canada, we have support in place in the UK, and that allows us to provide access for students to that support when they need it, to ensure they've got that initial support in place when they have that arrival in country. The next critical phase is that 1 to 6 month period. And the research is telling us that this is all about social. This is about now I've figured out where to go, I've figured out where the university is, I can understand how to navigate public transport, I've maybe built a couple of relationships, but I now need the social connectedness in order to help me navigate this journey that I'm on. And the social connectivity comes through very strongly on two main fronts. One is social connectivity from a study perspective, and one is purely from a social peer perspective. So if any students there are on the call today, IDP again has these offices on shore, and we have services in place to support that connectivity for you to arrange that social connection. Universities also provide excellent welcome and care services, and they also provide support around this particular key component of that journey. So the next phase in the journey really is taking us through to that sort of 6 to 12 month phase. And at this particular point, it gets really a little bit more complicated. We've arrived in country, we've navigated the various services, we've got our social connection in place, but now we're getting into the study. And now we're starting to get into finding part-time employment. We're looking at potentially volunteering options, and we're starting to explore how to experience the lifestyle and what's available in that destination country from both an education point of view, potentially an employment point of view, and a social point of view. And we see through the research access to support services around part-time jobs, around volunteering, internships becomes really, really important. Questions can often come up around migration. So I've now been here for a period of time, am I on track for what I need to do? Should I be considering a migration option? And again, that is where IDP has on shore services and support for migration, and services and support to help students at this point in their particular journey. So now our students gone through this particular experience, they're now getting really comfortable and confident in the destination country that they're in. So now we're into kind of that stage where we really want to bring in some success and start to really grow. And what we see from the research is that the need for that social connectivity continues, but we now start to get a much more expansive need around additional jobs, but also starting to be almost like an ambassador where I'm comfortable in country, I can engage with other students, and I'm able to actually advocate confidently that I'm here, I'm in a rhythm, I'm comfortable, and I'm off. So that first kind of period is really where we see those types of elements for our students in that journey. And again, along the bottom, IDP has onshore support for students in that journey. So when we look at what the research is telling us from a conclusion perspective, students really are saying that getting established in the country and city takes time, and it is brand new, it's daunting, but it's absolutely exciting as well, because you're on a journey that is so new and allows you to really build the skills that you have and really expand those skills into the market, into the country that you're experiencing. Alleviate any fears. They're looking for support, backup, being put at ease, connecting with others, making friends, contacts and networks. Also from a family perspective, the connectivity back to family and being able to stay connected to family through that journey is so much easier now with digital technology and what's available with systems such as WhatsApp, that really makes it a lot easier to stay in touch. But primarily set me up for success as I arrive in country, allow me the best possible chance to maximize my dream and my opportunity. So for IDP, we focus very much on the handshake, if you like, between the departure from the country you're coming from and the arrival into Australia. So we have pre-departure seminars that allow students to get ready to go. We have onshore services, particularly in Australia, with migration and number of products and services, which I'll talk about in a moment, that support our students onshore. We have onshore offices in Canada. And our counsellors are well versed in helping students sort of navigate that arrival into the destination country. So student essentials. I started off with the discussion around we've got you covered. So if you look at what the journey is for a student, if you look at what they've navigated, what can we do to help support the student? What products and services do students need in order to be successful in their journey? So this is information directly out of the research that's been done. And you'll see here that the question we asked was, when you're looking to leave the country to go to your destination, what are the things that are on your mind? What do you want to know? And this is the list of everything that our students were looking for. There's a whole range of different things. So I'm looking for maybe some additional support in English language. I'm looking to understand further about fees. I want to know more about how my admission is going to work and how I can get assistance around that. I might need assistance with financial aspects. But down the very bottom is by far the largest sort of chunk of things that our students are looking for and that we provide help with. One is that assistance in destination, general guidance or counselling. And the good news is IDP has counsellors in Australia that can provide additional counselling and support as you arrive. We also offer that, as I said, pre-departure assistance and destination general accommodation services. And accommodation is particularly important because that's your safety net, that's your home base, and that came through very strongly in the research. The next piece, as we looked at that journey that we went through earlier, was post-arrival. So I'm off the plane, I'm here, what's on my mind? Well, there's very practical things at this point. Banking services, maybe some questions you have around migration, picking me up at the airport, making sure I can safely get to my accommodation, support around quarantine type related questions associated with COVID, particularly topical right now, and particularly important as students navigate into their destination. Things such as access to other students that have done this before, other students I can talk to that can share their experiences and reassure me and put me at ease. Help me tour around the destination I've gone to. Help me understand the environment I'm in. What does it offer? What services are available? Is there a buddy I could connect to help me with that destination? And help me understand the events that are available that I could attend so that I can settle in and be supported in that journey. We also look to sort of summarize what are the sort of general themes that we can do to actually help our students in this process. And it really does form these common sort of concepts. So accommodation, need a roof over your head. Help me settle in, get me to some events so I know what's going on. Connect me to someone who can help me, whether it's a buddy or an alumni person. Help me tour around the destination and give me practical stuff, food, public transport, those types of things. So for student essentials, as I mentioned, we've got you covered. We actually have already in place with IDP a number of products and services that can help students navigate this journey and can support them at this arrival in their destination. So I want to share a little bit about what they look like, what's available, and for any students that are on the Conclave today, these are things you can access right now. For parents that might be in the Conclave today and might be worried about how do we get things in place to support your sons or daughters, these are the things that are available right now. And those are four core things that are very common to all students as they go through this transition from leaving their source country to their destination country. And the first up in the top left, you won't be surprised, is accommodation. Put a roof over my head. And IDP has a very extensive range of purpose-built student accommodation, PBSA. And purpose-built student accommodation means it's accommodation that's been designed specifically for students. It's priced specifically for students. It has support and services to help ensure students are safe and well looked after. And we have nearly all PBSA providers in Australia available to IDP. And we also are just launching for the UK the same range of purpose-built student accommodation for the UK market as well. And in fact, we'll actually have the largest selection choice in the UK available by any agent. We're investigating Canada, USA, and Ireland. But if you want to get a roof over your head, we can help you with that. The other options you have are things such as Airbnb, things such as networking with other students that are looking to travel to that destination. IDP can help you with that. attend the pre-departure seminars at IDP and meet other students in your cohort looking to study and seeing what they're doing, and our counsellors can help you with those types of conversations. The second, which is really important, actually even before you leave, is being able to safely transfer your money. There is a lot of providers out there that provide money transfer. IDP has secured what we believe are the most robust and reliable options. And to make sure that the fees are low or zero, that the rates are competitive, and that they're really easy to use. And that's important because sometimes you don't realize the rate that you're paying in the money transfer until you've done it, and by then it's too late. And you also want to be able to trust the provider that you're using when you're moving money, particularly paying tuition fees or moving money into a bank account to be ready for when you get to your destination. So we use Western Union, which is the world's largest money transfer business, Cohort Go, which is significantly expanded around the world, Flywire, and we've just recently launched the CIBC, which is the largest bank in Canada, known as the Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce, and they are an incredibly reputable organisation. For overseas health cover, this is about a compliance need. You need overseas health cover in order to study in Australia and to study in all our destinations. And IDP has access to all of the major providers for overseas health cover. And we're launched USA in 2021, and we're looking at other destinations right now. And then finally, really important, you're able to keep your money secure. So we have banking solutions available where you can set up your bank account before you leave, and you can make sure that you have money safe, secure, and ready for you when you arrive. We have Commonwealth Bank of Australia and CIBC in Canada. Finally, there's a whole bunch of other things coming, and these are things that are important to help our students as they settle into their destination countries. Up in the top left, mobile phones. We have discussions in place with telecommunications companies to allow you to have the right type of SIM card so you can stay connected, but more importantly, have access for our students to really good rates and really good rate plans so that they don't get into a rate plan or a rate card that's just not right, and it's just not providing the sort of competitive rates that students need. Bottom left, discounted flights for students, very hot topic at the moment with the Australia borders opening up. We're negotiating with airlines now to unlock discounted flights for students. In the middle there with the pig there, we're looking at some loan options to support students in arranging loans where they need it. A big topic of discussion on the top right is mental health, allowing the support for students if they do want some help, they do feel a bit uncomfortable, need to talk things through with people to have that available. And we're about to release a whole swag of discounts at shops, movies, and all sorts of other things for students to access. Okay, the good news, all of this is in your pocket. So the IDP Live app, the IDP student app that we have available, we are continuing to develop. Student Essentials is included in that app. You can access it in your pocket if you're a student, and that makes it really convenient to be able to manage all of your IDP experiences in one place. So with that, I'll open up for any questions. Appreciate this is a topic that may be of interest to folks that are looking to embark overseas. It may be of interest to folks that may be parents that may want to know a few things. So feel free to ask any questions you may have.
Thank you, Chris, for such an interesting download about aspects that are essential to prepare new students with. Small things, but they become really important when we think about banking, flights, accommodation, insurance, health, and also help. When students are going to a foreign destination, they need all of this ready and prepared. It was extremely useful. We have a couple of minutes to take a few more questions. We have one of the questions from our viewers here. Why and which insurances should we choose? Because there are some insurances that are university offers and some that IDP.
That is a fantastic question. We get asked this all the time. ultimately, it's about what's right for you as a student. So every student has a different need. Some students are very cost concerned and want to get the best cover at the best possible price. Other students are concerned more about a very comprehensive cover. And so cost perhaps isn't so important. Our counsellors have access to all of the insurance providers. It is actually your choice. So if you're going to Australia, I'll talk to you first. It is actually your choice of which insurance provider you choose. You don't have to choose the university's one. You don't have to choose IDP's recommended option. It's about choosing what's right for you. And what our counsellors can do is to provide you the options and you can make the selection that works for you, weighing up the quality of cover versus the cost of that insurance.
Thanks, Chris. There's another question. Would I have a point of contact to reach out to regarding any service issues later on arrival?
Yeah, good work. We do have in Australia a network of offices, IDP offices available. You can contact any IDP office in Australia. We're in Sydney, Brisbane, Melbourne, Perth, and Adelaide. We have offices in Canada you can reach out to if you're going to Canada. And you can always reach back to us via your IDP app to connect back to your counsellor if you need some support. So there are plenty of touch points where you can connect with us, and we actively encourage you to do so.
Another question around Canada. You mentioned that UK and Australia, there is accommodation support. How do I get it in Canada?
Coming soon. We're working with a provider at the moment. We're launching into the UK that has a lot of accommodation options in Canada. We haven't yet got that in place to have available on our app or with our counsellors, but we will do very soon. The thing with accommodation is to weigh up purpose-built student accommodation versus share housing versus Airbnb versus a referral from a friend or a family. It's pretty tough, right? Airbnb has a lot of content, but you don't always know what the quality of that content is. Our strong recommendation is purpose-built student accommodation is designed specifically for students. It's vetted by IDP. We know its quality. We know it provides a good experience for students. That's always our preferred recommendation.
That's great. Chris, one last question. Can I opt for these services online as well as through IDP website?
Yes, all of the services are available on our website. So if you go on to idp.com, you'll be able to navigate and you can actually secure the services yourself and actually self-serve all the way through and secure what you need. So whether you want to talk to one of our counsellors, whether you want to use our app, whether you want to use the website, whatever channel works for you and whatever experience works for you is fine.